Hey, good morning everybody and welcome back to the channel. Well, it's been very, very dark the last few days and this is the lightest the sky has been, and that's not great solar, but it is cranking out a few watts and it's been wet, but so dark that I broke my record of not using the generator, and for the past few days it's been running, and I'm glad I had that charger built into the system because that made it convenient. And there in the background you can see the shed, yet to be named, and I appreciate all you guys giving me all the suggestions. I think we've got a winner. I'm going to give it just a couple more days, but so many of those names I really did love, and I wrote them down, and I've been debating back and forth what I can call that. I think we've got one, and I'll let you guys know in the next couple days who wins that Victron charge controller for naming the little shack up there. Well, it's not really a shack. It's a it's going to be a little work studio, workshop, kind of a little bit of everything. But yeah, it's been great for all of you to play along and give me some good names for it. It's been so muddy up here. Got a little cleanup to do, but should be operating out of that in just the next couple of days. Supposed to get a nice break of weather and see some real sunshine and a little drying up, which will be good. And then right there, everything will be coming from there. So let's get on to today's video. I wanted to talk a little bit about that Victron smart charger. Hadn't had to fire that up in over a year. I think it's been about 14, 15 months since I ever really had to fire up a generator, but it's been so industrial out here the last week or so, draining the systems. I was draining batteries, chasing the power around left and right. And yeah, so I'll take you in and show you how it went. Yeah, we're gonna call that semi-sun today. Haven't really seen the sun. So here's what it looks like right now on a 500 watt string with that light sky that we've got going on right now, 103 watts coming in. And I'll show you the past few days what it's been looking like. And you can see, you know, it just was dark, darker, dark, 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 and so dark. Yesterday, what did I pull? 150 watt hours right there. Only 250, 350. So, very, very dark conditions. Nothing was keeping up. Draining batteries left and right. This is the lower string, which is 500 watts. The top string looks exactly like that for the past few days. Some of the times I was looking at this charge controller, there was 0 watts coming in. It was that dark. So what I had to do, and what I did build into this system, was this Victron Energy Blue Smart Charger. This is the 12 volt, 30 amp charger. And I had to fire up my 2000 watt generator and just plug this in. And you can see, and I showed you guys a couple of years ago when I tied this in for exactly these kind of conditions. So once I fire up my generator, I can just plug this in and just, you know, run that generator out. It holds about 1 gallon of gas. I was filling it up and just letting it run till it ran out of gas. And it made the big difference in keeping the main house bank charged up. So like right now, you know, I took it up to about 90% yesterday after 2 full days of running it. And it's got a refrigerator tied into it. So 70% right now, a couple hundred watts coming in off the both strings. So it's doing fine now, but it was no way gonna keep up to par. So yeah, that little smart charger there, really, really love that. Haven't used it in well over a year, but it was just plug and play and could keep the work going on here. So very happy about that. And this little backup system that I was using, 500 watts of solar coming into this system too. And right now, 100 watts coming in there. And if I go to the history, you know, it all looked very much the same. I was draining batteries because there was just no sun coming in. And you can see yesterday, only 140 watt hours. So hardly anything's been coming in. Been dancing batteries around, making it all work. And like I said, lots of little construction projects been going on here. Everything's been working real hard. And in the next couple days, we should get some good sunshine. But this one, I'm just letting the sun bring it back up slowly. It says it's up to about 32% right now, down there on my gauge. But yeah, that's what it's been looking like. And I drained the 48 volt battery down to nothing this morning. The inverter tripped the alarm. We had a freezer tied up to that and it was getting low. I thought it might make it to today, but it ran out early this morning. And interestingly enough, even though it is slowly charging right now, and you can see by that blue light it is on, it doesn't show up on my app list right now. And I'm not sure why I can't see it on the application list. It should be showing up, but it's not showing up. That's kind of puzzling to me because I can see my 24 volt, little system in the bedroom, the chins. Everything shows up, but that 48 volt battery, since it was drained this morning, but it's up and running right now. I'm actually got the freezer tied back into it, but it doesn't show back up on my list. So I'm not sure why that's happening and I'm not sure how to get it back on there. So that's really puzzling to me because I'm sitting here looking at the apps or the app list on the Victron charge controllers that I'm running. And ever since I drained that 48 volt this morning, it will not reappear. So I can see that it is charging and I am running something like I said, but it will not show up on my list. And usually when you tie in one of those charge controllers to a battery, you know, you can see it on your list, but that one won't come back. So if any of you guys have a suggestion about that, I don't know, maybe I should turn it off and disconnect it from the battery and then redo it. Something must have got tripped up on that, but yeah, that 48 volt will not show up right now. Okay, I kind of answered my own question and I'll go ahead and show you guys what I did. So now you can see my 48 volt came back on. 700 watts of solar out there with 147 watts coming in. So what I did, in case any of you ever run across this problem too, I did drain that battery. Like I said, the inverter was chirping early this morning, came in, shut the system down to make that noise stop, and then it never came back on to my device list on the Victron app. So I was just puzzling about this. So what I did, first thing is I disconnected my solar panels, and then I flipped all my breakers off that I've got. Like there's one down there to the battery, one there to the inverter, that I like to have those quick disconnects. So I took the panels off first, flipped that isolator switch down, no solar coming in, disconnected everything, and then I simply just re-snapped those back to the on position on those quick release, and it came right back on. So that's all I had to do, in case any of you ever run up against that. That wasn't a big issue, but I've been running around here for about a half an hour going, where did my 48 volt battery go to? So there it is. Not much power coming in, but it's going to at least get something. Because like I said, in the past few days, it wasn't uncommon to look up here and see 0 watts coming in. It was dark, and early in the day too. So, okay, that's all I had to do. Off with the panels, disconnect the battery, everything, reconnect it real quick, and there she is. What a relief.
Okay, well, it's about time to get back to work. Got a lot of different projects tying together. Get ready for the first of the year. Don't think I'm going to have to run the generator today. Maybe a little bit to run it in conjunction with the sun, which is actually, still not visible. Okay, well, if I need to, I'll fire up that generator. But yeah, I broke my record of trying not to use that generator. But I went about 14 or 15 months without actually needing it. But this is the time of the year where it can really flush out your systems, and sometimes you actually have to break down and do it. So I had to burn a little over 2 gallons. I guess I ran it 2.5 days. So I probably ran 2.5 gallons of gas in the past 3 days. And what is that? About $5 a gallon out here. So yeah, we can call it $15 to keep everything up and running. First time I've had to spend a dime on the solar in a year and a half or so. So no complaints there. That's why I keep the backup generator for backup.
So I hope all of you are having a good lead into your holidays. It's going quite well out here. Been having some company, as I showed you on a couple of little short videos last night. We had a little incident where my dad took a nosedive into the swimming pool trying to help me keep that thing from overflowing. And the next day, probably tomorrow, I'm gonna be able to get up here and load this up. So, and this is just one of about 4 or 5 different projects been trying to tie together all at the same time. So very, very busy, but getting ready to wind down starting this weekend. And I'll be coming at you live from here. Yeah, there's no real solar. So Merry Christmas to everybody. I will announce the winner of that Victron charge controller for naming this place. I'm almost 100% certain I've got the name in mind, and it was suggested by one of you, so I'll keep you in suspense for a couple more days. Hope everything's going good for everybody. Right on. Aloha.
Getting pretty excited out here. Well, I'll have to show you some of the other things that we did. It was a real push. I was crawling around on my hands and knees and barely able to get up. But it's all good fun. All right, everybody. Thanks for tuning in as always. I'll be back at you in just a couple of days. Got a good review to show you on a very, very cool little battery thing. And that's about all I can think of right now. Take care. Where is that sun? I think it's over there, somewhere up in there.